My name is Emily Riehl, and I work at Johns Hopkins University in Baltimore. I did like math always, as long as I can remember. And I think just because I was more interested in it than other people, I was always pretty good at it too, because I spent more time thinking about it. I first wanted to become a mathematician when I first learned what mathematics really was, which was in the middle of high school. I started to learn about proofs and learn how creative mathematics really is. And that's when I decided I wanted to be a mathematician. So I work in an area called category theory. And one of my friends, Eugenia Chang, describes category theory as the mathematics of mathematics. So what I work on is proving very general theorems that will then apply in lots of different areas of mathematics simultaneously for the same reason. And the way that works is we're kind of taking a bird's eye view of the practice of mathematics itself. So we're thinking about mathematical objects of all sorts of different kinds and their relationships to each other. So a few years ago, I discovered that a theorem that I had written about in a published paper was actually incorrect. Or actually what happened is the theorem was true, but the proof that I had written was wrong. And what made this so painful is it was a collaborative paper. So there were four people on the paper, but it was my fault. I was the one who proposed that particular proof and wrote that draft and told everybody else that this is correct. And it was actually completely incorrect. So that was a very bad week. I was stayed up very late and trying to figure out whether the theorem was true or not, even though the proof was wrong. And fortunately in the end it was. And so all of our applications were okay. And we just needed to admit that we made a mistake and put in a new proof. But what was interesting and I guess lucky about this story is when it happened, I had been doing mathematics for a decade plus at that point. And you know, I recognized that it was a mistake and it was distressing certainly, but it didn't really make me doubt myself or doubt my place in mathematics. And I think it's just important to remember. And this is just a very, very common experience, I'd venture, that all professional mathematicians have published mistaken proofs, and it's not the end of the world. So one thing that is a bit unusual about me for an academic mathematician is I've spent a lot of time writing books for other mathematicians at various career stages. So for people on the cusp of graduate school or for research level mathematicians. And I think the things that I'm most proud of are those books, some of which contain some theorems that I've proven, but others are just purely expository and are meant to explain the mathematics that I love. So it turns out mathematics is a very social discipline, and we spend a lot of time traveling to visit each other and to go to conferences and to go to workshops, and during the pandemic, of course, but at other times. And you very quickly get to know the other people in your community. And I feel like I have so many close friends who are kind of near my career stage and role models who are in the generation older in all of the academic fields where I work. And there are just a lot of really wonderful people who are interested in the same types of mathematics as I am. And that's part of what makes it a lot of fun. One of the things that has surprised me as somebody who's always loved math and has always been pretty good at it is how much better I am as a mathematician than I was just a few years ago. And I remember noticing this, I think, particularly when I was in college, that you know, ideas that I found very confusing the first time I met them, you know, a year or two later felt extremely natural and very intuitive. And, you know, now 10 years later, I feel like I've forgotten that they were ever confusing. And, you know, you'll try and read a research paper, you'll try and read a book in a particular field that's new to you and it doesn't make any sense, but you come back to it a year or two later and all of a sudden you can understand it and start to see connections to other areas. So I think the thing that's most important if you're interested in going on in mathematics is finding some areas that really interest you, something that you're excited to come back to day in after day after day after day. And if you have that sort of love for what you're doing, it's gonna get better all the time.